subscribe to my channel. Thanks. Stains, France for voters in the poorer, largely immigrant suburbs of Paris. The motivation to turn out for France's presidential runoff seems clear, to defeat Marine Le Pen, the far-right leader of the National Front, who has pitched her campaign against immigrants and Muslims. The other candidate, the centrist Emmanuel Macron, would seem to be an easy alternative. But the reality of this election cycle in towns like Staines, where public frustration is high over the failure of politicians to deliver on past promises, is that many voters may simply choose to stay home on May 7th for the critical, final vote. Don't count on the working-class neighborhoods this year to save France, said Inès Sedighi, a 26-year-old French Muslim in Staines, whose parents came from Morocco. Although Ms. Sedighi said she would vote reluctantly for Mr. Macron, she feared she was an exception. White people who say you have to vote against Marine Le Pen because you will lose more than we will don't realize that for us, we already live in a racist country. In the first round of the presidential election on April 23, voters in many poorer Parisian suburbs did turn out, but for the fiery candidate on the extreme left, Jean-Luc Mélenchon, who channeled the anger of communities neglected by the political system. And many also chose not to vote. That second option, not voting, is now a real possibility in the final round for those who previously voted for Mr. Mélenchon, even though they arguably have the most at stake. Just how many voters abstain could determine whether Ms. Le Pen can upend expectations and beat Mr. Macron. The prevailing assumption is that a broad majority of voters, a so-called Republican front that includes the poorer suburbs, will come together behind Mr. Macron in the name of turning back Ms. Le Pen and the far right. But a low turnout could threaten this belief and help Ms. Le Pen. In France's poor suburbs, many French are of Arab extraction with parents or grandparents who came from Algeria, Morocco, or Tunisia. Many are also from sub-Saharan Africa, the former French colonies of Ivory Coast, Mali, Senegal, and Togo, and what was once French Indochina, today's Cambodia, Laos, and Vietnam. For them, neither the right nor the left has delivered when it comes to making jobs more available and reducing discrimination. Recent terrorist attacks have worsened the stigma attached to immigrants and Muslims. A number of the house searches after the terror attacks in and around Paris on November 13, 2015, were conducted by police in Saint-Estédenis, the political jurisdiction that includes Staines.